going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Kyle Poole and I'm a photographer and video creator. If you're new here, consider subscribing, turn the bell on so you can get notified for all future videos, and let's get into today's video. So today we're gonna go over my favorite lens to take portraits, my favorite lens to take most photos because of the focal length, the Sigma 35mm 1.4 Art Series lens. Now, this is not a new lens by any means. This is a relatively older lens. This is also a not stabilized lens. So for anyone doing video, just something to keep in mind that this is not a stabilized lens. This lens has been on my camera for just under the past year, and it's kind of been like my go-to lens for most stuff, especially for photography. The 35mm focal range is actually quite nice, and then that it goes down to 1.4, you can shoot a lot better in lower light situations. It gives a beautiful bokeh to your background. It's just like an all-around, like, pretty solid lens for photography. Now, I think everyone probably knows that because it's, you know, it's a 35mm, it's 1.4, it's gonna look beautiful. The actual bokeh on it is quite nice. 35 is a really desired focal range because it's kind of true to how your eye would see things for a lot of the time. And all around, like, most people would probably say the 35mm 1.4, great for weddings, great for portraits, just great for a lot of stuff, really. So I'm not gonna really get into anything like that because you guys already know that. I'm gonna bring up some points for video because I predominantly do video. I love taking photos, but most of my clients are video clients. And I will say that this lens is decent for video. It's not phenomenal. It's not terrible. It's decent. In terms of the actual focal length for video, it looks great. 35mm is awesome. The 1.4 is just buttery smooth. The one thing that just, like, bugs me a little bit is the autofocus. Now, that is because it's not a native Canon lens. Obviously, if this was a 35mm 1.4 Canon RF glass, the quality is gonna be better because it's made for Canon. Canon produces it for this particular camera. It's made for R5, R6, or R. So obviously it's gonna be better. But at the same time, it's gonna be substantially more money. If you are on more of a budget, the Sigma 35mm art lens is gonna be a baller lens for you. I mean, in terms of actual picture quality, if you can get the autofocus to be spot on, which for the most part I don't have a problem doing, sometimes it's a little slow when you're filming someone talking or something like that, and you're moving, they're moving, it's in a lower light situation being 1.4, the autofocus can be a little janky. It's not perfect, where if I put my 24 to 105, it's crisp. It's like this with the autofocus. It's immediately substantially better. A lot of the time for this angle that we're watching right now, this currently is a 24 to 105, but a lot of the time it's my 35mm and it doesn't really have a problem, you know, being in focus and making sure my eye is detected and all of that. So in terms of, you know, a stationary shot, it's pretty fine. I noticed the other day I was filming a studio walkthrough and I was walking, you know, with a gimbal, keeping focus on someone talking and they're turning and moving. And it was having a bit of a hard time staying in focus. So that's just something to keep in mind if, you know, you are getting this predominantly for video purposes. It's good for the price. I'm not sure what the price of an RF 35mm 1.4 would be, but I would assume probably like at least $2,000, maybe closer to three, where the Sigma lens comes in more in the 1,300 range, on sale 1,000. So it's substantially less money, pretty similar quality. If you're getting it for photo and video, it's a no-brainer because for photo, it sells itself. It's phenomenal and I have nothing but great things to say about it. The autofocus, again, is just a tad slower than obviously a native Canon lens, but that's obvious. We know that. We know that Canon produces a better quality lens for a Canon camera. For photography, this lens has been a killer lens. I have nothing but amazing things to say about this lens for photography. Don't necessarily love how it weighs like 5 pounds. Like, it's super heavy. Like, the whole weight of the camera is this lens. Like, it's substantially heavy. It looks really good on the camera though. Like, being just a blacked out, really, like, well-built, like, metal lens, it's a nice quality lens. I use it for product photography because of the low light capabilities and really isolating a subject with the 1.4. For the most part, I'm really happy with it. I don't have many negative things to say other than for video. For the whole, the video thing is a separate category because you need to make sure the autofocus is good. Stabilization is always better than not stabilized because It's gonna make your job a lot easier. It's gonna make it smoother. This lens is not stabilized. So that's just something that's another negative for the video side of things, is it's not stabilized. When you're using a gimbal, you have to really take into consideration how heavy this lens is, because it has a little bit more of a shake because of how much weight is on the gimbal. So pretty substantial negative effects that I would have for, you know, video side of things for this lens. Like, I ended up getting this lens for $800, I think. Like, for $800, like, this is a really good lens. For photo, it's phenomenal. For video, it's good. For $800, $1,000, $1,200, you're not gonna get something that's this good. If you're on a budget, you're thinking about maybe upgrading a lens, you like shooting portraits, you kind of like shooting a wide variety of things, you can look at my Instagram and you could probably pick out when I got this lens to, you know, before I had this lens, because of how good it is. And it is the Art series. So the Art series is a really desired series of lenses, and you're gonna get a unique style of photo and video with it. I think moving forward for photography, I most certainly would look into some Sigma lenses for myself. In terms of video, I think I would probably stick with the native Canon RF glass, just because it's one more consistent. Yeah, it's way more money, but at the same time, it's made for the camera I'm using. I don't have to use the adapter. I don't have to use any of those things. So for photo, I'm most certainly going to be looking at some Sigma lenses moving forward. I was pleasantly surprised by this 35mm. Anyways, that's pretty much going to wrap it up for me, guys. This was a short one. I appreciate all the love and support I've been getting on the channel. If you haven't already, subscribe, click the like button, hit the bell so you can get notified for future videos, and I will catch you guys in the next video.